just finished up a lovely feature for the Angler's Mail where I've been doing a few different methods. I've been drop shotting and I've been wobbling in Warrington on the Bridgewater Canal with none other than my old mucker, Steve Daley, with this fascinating method. And I want to show you, and hopefully Steve's going to show you exactly what it's all about. So Steve, take it away, mate. What's all this wobbling about?
Good afternoon. Well, what you do with the first leading hook is you put it through the top of the mouth like so.
Yeah.
And the next hook down, you just make a little kink in the fish.
So what's the kink in the fish for, mate? You've got
to... Just to make it swim like a live bait.
Oh, of course. So you're going to get a little bit of...
So it moves like it's actually alive.
Right. And then basically the technique is what, mate?
Basically the technique is to draw the pike that are lying on the bottom up, thinking it's a fish in distress.
Got you.
Like so.
Oh, I can really see that, yeah.
Usually
really
8 times out of 10 that will work.
So if I'm going to try it for the first time then, mate, for the first time today, I've hooked it, so you've shown me how to hook it.
Yep.
Obviously you need a wire trace.
Yep, wire
what
trace.
What kind of braid are you using?
20 pound Power Pro.
20 pound Power Pro braid. I've hooked it like this, I've put a kink in.
Yep.
I've chucked it out. So do you twitch it back? Do you keep retrieving it? Do you leave it? What exactly do you do with it?
All depends how it is on the day. I'd twitch it back.
Right.
It seems to have better results.
Right.
So if
you're going to chuck it out here, yep, then, for instance, on this swim?
Just let it sink a little bit. Probably
right.
Give it about 5-10 seconds.
Just to let it go?
Just twitch it.
I can see it actually moving then.
It goes from side to side like so. If you reel it back straight, it just tends to come in a bit too fast and come up too quick.
So the quick jerky movements.
Quick jerky movements.
It is like a dying fish, isn't it, mate?
It's like a dying fish.
So if I get a pike then, mate, what do you do? Do you pike line or do you hit it straight away?
If it's right under your feet and you can see it's actually tucked the fish whole, you can more or less hit it straight away. But if it's tucked it halfway across, three quarters of the way across and you can't see, I'd let it give a little bit of line first.
Fantastic.
Then do a countdown strike.
It's an awesome method. I'll tell you what, you've got to have a look at the Angler's Mail, see how devastating this method is, and give it a go.